I'm going to give you some more words.
Virginia Beach City Public Schools is on a journey to ensure that each and every student has the skills needed to thrive as 21st century learners, workers, and citizens. The division's strategic plan, Compass to 2015, serves as the roadmap. It stresses the need for rigor, relevance, and relationships in the classroom. To identify best practices, central administration, principals, and teachers have initiated a series of learning walks, visits to classrooms, to get a snapshot of the teaching and learning taking place.
We feel that learning walks are a bird's eye view of good instruction.
So really the way the learning walks work is we go to a school. Cabinet members have a number of schools that we visit, where we go into the school working with the principal, and then we decide on a list of look-fors, items that we want to see and practices we want to see occurring in the classroom. And we call these look-fors. And critical thinking was the focus as we got started with this last year.
Once the list of look-fors is reviewed, the team visits a small number of classrooms for about 5 to 10 minutes each, taking notes as they go. They're watching, for example, to see how well students generate and grapple with higher order questions, analyze and solve new problems by generating a variety of ideas and solutions, and adapt learned knowledge to more complex, ambiguous situations. Do they use and explain the right method of thinking? Evaluate and communicate their own thinking? Defend positions with justification based on factual evidence and data? And finally, are students engaged in authentic learning activities or creating authentic work? And making connections and predictions using prior knowledge? Obviously, not all of these look-fors will be seen during a brief learning walk, but the team does get a sense of the learning taking place. After spending time in the selected classrooms, the team sits down to talk about what they observed. On this day, the team visited third grade classes at Trantwood Elementary. In one class, students took part in a hands-on science lab looking at owl pellets to figure out what the bird had eaten.
I had one child who pulled out a skull and he had narrowed it down, he said, to two possibilities of what type of rodent it might be. And then when I asked him how he had arrived at that, how he had narrowed it down, he showed me the eye sockets, the size of the eye sockets, and the teeth. So he was making, you know, some inferences, you know, based on what he'd learned that I thought were very intuitive, and he seemed to understand the scientific method of observation.
In another class, students were taking part in a math lesson focused on decimals.
82 cents, but 82 hundredths of what?
A dollar.
Absolutely.
You need to have that direct teaching,
yes,
which is what she was involved in, but she did get the students involved. The students were interacting with each other. They were working in pairs. One of the things I noticed was when she was questioning a student, she didn't let him off the hook right away when he didn't know the answer. She gave lots of wait time, which ties into those higher level questions that we were talking about earlier. If you're going to ask those higher level questions, you need to make sure you give students time to respond.
At the end of the learning walk, the team looks at the patterns or themes that may be emerging school-wide and also considers possible next steps for enhancing student learning. Each principal then shares the information with school staff.
We do. We receive feedback in many different ways. First of all, our administrators will leave little notes on our desk so that we'll get immediate feedback right after the walkthrough. And also, our administrators will chat with us, perhaps over lunch. We eat lunch together and ask if they can share what they saw with the faculty meetings, with our short tweet sharings. They also will highlight what they've seen in our faculty bulletins weekly. So there's several different ways that we receive feedback from the walkthroughs.
At many schools, teachers are also going on learning walks, observing their peers and sharing teaching strategies. While the original focus has been on critical thinking in the classroom, teams will soon broaden their scope to look for examples of collaboration and communication along with other 21st century skills. Ultimately, learning walks will improve the teaching and learning taking place in our classrooms and more clearly define the expectations we have for students and staff.